academic and not academic, how in UPSC journeys? And second question is, what not to do in our UPSC journeys?
I have to realize that it is going to be a long journey. You'll see that you are in a tunnel and there's no end to it. But you have to find the shortest way out of that tunnel. And you have to have a very strong reason why you want to come into civil services. Because there will be moments where you'll be very high, like, aaj to machai denge, 20 ghante pad lenge. And there will be very lot of moments where you'll feel like, ab to chhod do, nahi hoga. So have that strong reason. Once you come and start your preparation, see what is required. See, people have this perception that the IAS, the people who get into the services are great. It is not true. See, whatever be my academic past, whether I'm from an IIT or I have a 9-pointer, anything, it doesn't really matter. Everyone starts from scratch once we are preparing for civil services. So you have to see what is required, how to approach for it. It is not going to come all of a sudden to you. It will take time. And you will realize throughout your journey, you will do mistakes, you will realize your mistakes, and you will correct it. Even when I started preparing, if I look at the notes that I made in the beginning, and if I look at the notes that I made towards the end, there's a huge difference in that. If I look at my answers, the very first answer that I wrote, I think it was a 150 words question. I wrote, I think, around 400-500 words in that. But it is important that you start it. Writing an essay, most people feel that, okay, fine, we'll write it after prelims. Some people say that I didn't even write any essay and I just wrote it in the exam. Okay, it may be good for them. But if you have time, go for it. Make sure that you do whatever is required so that you don't regret after the exam that, okay, I didn't do this or I missed on this. So if you are planning on it, go for one attempt. Make sure that you do whatever is required to clear it in the first attempt itself. Otherwise, you get trapped in a very vicious cycle.
Completely agree with whatever he said. But I want to ask you one question. What is the goal that you're talking about? What is your goal? I mean, for example, my goal was to find my name on the final list. What is your goal?
My goal is to crack UPSC in a first attempt.
Right.
So, yeah.
So keep everything that you do, keep that in mind. And if there's something that you're doing that is making you guilty, like someone was talking about here, don't do it. That is a don't. Everything that is making you feel that you're going closer to your goal, do that. These are the do and don'ts. And I think this is what it boiled down in my journey. If you take a net, I think I've done more do's than don'ts. I've done a lot of don'ts also, but just do more do's, that's all.
And one thing is very important. We all see toppers interviews on YouTube, right? Not the mock interview, the interview that they give to the coaching institutions. We all focus on how they did it. Like, what were their sources? How much time did they study? See, the reality of each and every individual is different. You may have some other reality. You may have some other restrictions. I have some other background. I have some other restriction. So every individual will have his own strategy. And very importantly, just focus on, while watching those interviews, focus on what not to do. Everybody knows what to do, right? Everybody knows which book to read. Everybody knows what to do, right? How to write an answer. But nobody focuses on what not to do. So while watching those interviews, please see what not to do. Especially for people who are like given a third attempt, fourth attempt. See what mistakes they have done. Introspect whether you are also making that mistake or not. And if you are, don't do it. It's as simple as possible.